CNN's New York headquarters, the Moneyline News Hour.
Now let's listen into the auction of that baseball that's going on across the street at Madison Square Garden.
1,000,000 They changed the game plan. 1,600,000
1,600,000
The next bid you want in is 1,600,000 1,600,000 you need to be. It's on the tele. Yes, bid over there at 1,000,000
Gone.
How much would you pay for President John F. Kennedy's private notes, his sailboat, humidor, or even his pajamas?
More than 500 items that once belonged to President John F. Kennedy and his wife
will be offered to the public at Guernsey's Auction House here in New York City.
Camelot goes on the block. A Kennedy treasure trove from a man who once said he would not sell.
You mean to tell me these items are not for sale?
Absolutely not for sale.
In a way, that's almost fighting words.
The one thing you wouldn't trade, you wouldn't part with, you wouldn't sell.
The briefcase he used through his whole political career. It was on the plane in Dallas. It has the ambiance to me of Kennedy.
This is his Hermes briefcase, which apparently he loved, and rather than get a new one, he kept getting this one repaired.
The president, because of his back pain, preferred rocking chairs. There are about a dozen in the world. This one and one like it came from New York's Carlisle, which was known as the New York White House while he stayed here.
All of his handwriting is seen here. Tell me, this was from a trip he took, correct?
There were many documents in sale. This one was from a 1945 trip throughout Europe, pointing out his perceptive thoughts about the future of the Cold War.
All right, this is the humidor?
The president was a great cigar smoker.
This would be a very cool thing to own because it has a silver plaque. Yeah.
This one was on the Oval Office desk and still contains cigars that he gave out to friends. Considered one of the most valuable watches in the world. He wore it throughout the presidency, and we're privileged to have it here.
Jackie's Pillbox
hat. Famous hat that set a trend for the nation.
The John F. Kennedy auction will be held in New York City on March 18th. And 19th.
Mr.
Tuckman is standing by. Gary Tuckman, you want to talk about it?
$100,000
is the next bid. Over here on the telephone at $1,700,000
$1,800,000
the next bid. Is there any advance now beyond
$1,700,000? Let's listen.
You want to own a piece of the king? Elvis memorabilia that has been under lock and key for 20 years. The auction is taking place over a three-day period in October. That will be the 8th, the 9th, and the 10th.
Here with the preview is Arlen Ettinger, president of Guernsey's Auction House, joining us in our studios today. And this is all to go toward building the homeless shelter. And this takes place when?
October 8th, 9th, and 10th.
Now what would you pay if I tell you that this belonged to the king of rock and roll, Elvis Presley? These are the actual keys, Elvis's keys to Graceland.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog, girl. You cry all the time.
This 1956 Lincoln Continental Mark II was one of Elvis Presley's favorite cars. He kept it for over 20 years.
This is just one of two pairs of his fatigues, his actual fatigues. You see, he became a sergeant.
This is one of three that was done by an artist named Ralph Wolf Cowan. Apparently, Elvis Presley never slept in the nude, didn't sleep in boxers and briefs. He only liked to wear pajamas. This almost seems too good to be true that this type of variety of items were found in here.
This is the contract that made him a major recording artist. This jumpsuit was worn by Elvis at Las Vegas in 1971, became the cover art for a tour catalog he produced.
This is not a stage costume.
No, Elvis was always on stage.
Finally. あのマグワイアの打った70号ボールが姿を現した。
$1,900,000 is bid, and $2 million now. $2 million you need to be. It's on the telephone at $1,900,000, and now $2 million. Yes, $2 million.
Okay, tell.
Okay, sorry, I'm having too much fun just wearing them. Tell me a little bit about this necklace and how it happened to be in Guernsey's hands now.
This necklace was very much the creation of Diana, who worked with the crown jeweler to use South Sea pearls and more than 200 diamonds to her liking. She wore it on this very special occasion, gave it back to the jeweler to have the matching earrings made, and then her tragedy occurred. The Queen and Diana's family, along with Garrod, the royal jeweler, got together and suggested that it should be sold. Timing of this make it the only piece that probably ever will be sold. We're conducting the sale right before Christmas, and on behalf of Guernsey's, we certainly think it's the gift of the century.
来年1月12日、マディソンスクエアガーデンで値段。
And now $2,100,000. 2,100,000, you need to be on the telephone. Do you want 2,100,000? 2,100,000 is bid, and now 2,200,000 on the telephone at $2,100,000 and $2,200,000. $2,200,000 is the next bid. Is there any advance on the bid beyond $2,100,000?
Hey there, I'm here at the Rock and Roll Memorabilia Auction. Gonna look at some cool stuff, gonna buy some stuff, and maybe even try and sell some stuff. Let's go. I'm standing here next to the original sign for Max Yazger's farm, site of the first Woodstock in 1969. The price of this sign has just escalated because the last surviving cow died of a swollen heart. This, ladies and gentlemen, is Elvis Presley's Remington Razor.
Yes, $2,200,000. And now $2,300,000. $2,300,000 is bid. And now $2,400,000. Last chance, fair warning to everybody selling to the telephone at $2,300,000. Last call to everybody. Do you want in at $2,400,000? $2,400,000 is over there. And now $2,500,000. $2,500,000 to the telephone, it's bid. And now $2,600,000. $2,600,000. Now you need to be $2,600,000. $2,600,000, it's over here at $2,500,000. $2,500,000 and $2,600,000. Do you want in at $2,600,000? On the telephone at $2.5 million and $2,600,000. The next bid, is there any advance on the bid now beyond $2,500,000? $2,600,000? Fair warning to everybody, it's on the phone over here at $2,500,000. Selling one, $2,600,000. And $2,700,000. $2,700,000 you need to be. $2,700,000 to the telephone at $2,700,000. $2,700,000 you need to be now. $2,700,000. $2,700,000 is the next bid. We're out here at $2,600,000. $2,700,000. And now $2,800,000. $2,800,000 needs to be the next bid. We're over here at $2,700,000. And $2,800,000 is next. Is there any advance on the bid beyond $2,700,000? Anybody want in at $2,800,000? We're on the telephone at $2,700,000. Fair warning to everybody, selling to the phone once, twice, sold to the phone for $2,700,000.
Failed! Number 70! How much? Jana, a lot of people expected this ball to go for at least $1 million. Some people said at least $2 million, but this $2.7 million plus the commission of $305,000, people did not expect that. The most money ever paid for any sports artifact at any time.